Hello friends, I advocate Pratap Singh Ahluwalia. I along with my team of 20 advocates are into legal consultancy all over India. This video is regarding custody of child. We'll discuss custody of child or parent seeking divorce because that is most important factor for parents who plan to end their marriage. Natural parents are also called biological parents. This is one issue where both the parents have a lot of controversy, which is followed by maintenance of the children. So I'll discuss only custody and maintenance will be discussed in next video to save complication. The mother and father both have an equal right to the custody of a child. The courts in India are very strict to ensure that a child gets the affection of both the parents. The other parents get visitation right, the condition of which are determined by the court. Child custody law. The law governing child custody cases in India falls under two acts, Guardian and Wards Act and Hindu Marriage Act. Hence, the application for custody of child for interim or permanent is moved under Guardians Act and Section 26 of Hindu Marriage Act. But sometimes in emergency, we have to move a writ petition also under Article 32 and 226 of Constitution of India in High Court or Supreme Court. Place where child custody can be filed is an important factor. Child custody cases are filed in the jurisdiction of the family court or competent court where minor child ordinary resides. For example, father is living in Mumbai, mother is living in Delhi along with minor child. If father wants to file child custody, he has to file the same only in Delhi. Thus, family court or concerned competent courts shall have the exclusive jurisdiction over the child custody to the exclusion of all other courts. Here, ordinarily resides is an important word and has been decided by courts in various cases as per the facts of the case. Procedure for filing child custody is very simple. A petition of child custody for declaring appointment of natural or legal guardian of a minor child is done by filing a petition by the spouse seeking child custody. One has a child, other one doesn't have a child, so the one who do not have a child right now with him files a petition. In child custody cases, non-custodial parents seeks the custody and guardianship of the minor child. Such petition usually take long time. Thus, application for interim or temporary custody as well as visitation rights are also filed by non-custodial parent, the one who is not having a custody of child at that moment. Visitation right implies regular meeting of the minor child with the non-custodial parent. General duration of visiting rights varies from 1 to 4 meetings per month. Then there is interim custody, implies generally overnight custody or long hours of custody for a defined period to the non-custodial parent with undertaking to restore the custody of child upon completing the defined time by handing it over back to the custodial parent. Custodial parent is required to give reasons to the petition, following which evidence are led by both parents. After closure of evidence by both parents, their respective witness, if any, there follows an argument and consequently a judgment is given by the court. As told before, in certain situations, in emergencies, a writ petition under Article 32 of the Constitution of India can be filed in Supreme Court, or a writ petition under 226 of the Constitution of India can be filed in High Courts. Such exceptional situations arise when one parent unlawfully takes the children from the custody of other parent, or unlawfully retains, keeps with him the custody of the children, or father or mother, as the case may be, has taken the child out of the country. So such kind of situations where we need to file the writ petition. Such petition is filed in nature of writ of habeas corpus for the child custody. It is filed for the expeditious determination of the issue. It is not a full-fledged child custody petition having, but has limited jurisdiction. However, Supreme Courts or High Courts are vested with extraordinary powers, jurisdiction to determine the issue. Timing of filing such petition is utter importance. Now, key points are there. Child custody cases are emotionally taxing for the parties and also for the counsels, as well as the judges. Generally, the age of majority is 18 years, and in some cases, it is 21 years. Nowadays, court often takes the help of experts such as counselors, psychologists, or other specialists dealing with the issues of child custody. It is extremely interesting to note that all judgments that attain finality bound parties with final outcome. However, the decision of judgment of child custody are never final. That means it can be challenged with the change of circumstances. If the welfare of child is affected by any act of the custodial parent, then the non-custodial parent can file child custody petition claiming the custody of child on the basis of changed circumstances, where the court can issue directive accordingly. Now, as per ITI response, it shows that 83 child custody matters that went to court in a year, only in two cases custody was awarded to father. 50% overnight vacation is given to only one parent. Generally, the custody of child, girl child, is given to mother as she is considered better parent than father. Legally speaking, the Guardian and Wards Act give a complete power to court to decide the guardianship of a child. This is often called legal custody in common use. Other kinds of custodies often used in common legal languages are sole custody, where one parent is the sole caretaker of the child, joint custody, where both the parents are responsible for the child, third party custody, where a third party, that is grandparents or somebody other than the parents, get the custody of child. The Karnataka High Court said that it is the most natural thing for a child to grow up in the company of their mother, and a child gets the best protection and education only through the mother, even in nature. This was a case where the divorced mother, Chetanna, married famous cricketer Anil Kumble. The court granted the mother with custody of child, considering the happy environment, stability and well-being that she would be able to provide. Supreme Court was bent towards giving a mother custody of her minor child, but the child wanted to live with her father after the couple was mutually divorced. The court, considering the fact that child wants to live with her father, decided that father would get the custody of child. If the child is not minor, they have a right to choose their custodian. And even when the minors express their views, the court makes sure to consider them and use them to inform their final decision. General considerations before court while deciding child custody cases are like financial stability of the custodial parent, but it is not very dominant. Generally, wives are not working. So it is not a view that since wives are not working, they are not financially stable, they will not get the custody. So it is not a very dominant part. Second is education qualification or respective spouse and of their immediate respective family members. This is one very important. Then wishes of the minor child, if he can form opinion of his own. Mental and physical well-being. The child's comfort with the said parents, especially while growing up. The intention of custodian. There should not be any malafide, wrong or false intention that may harm the child. No specific gender has a right or the child and above the welfare of the child. The judge has a full right to decide what is best for the child. The child may also choose for themselves. It is not the child over whom the parents can fight over or claim. It is only the child's welfare, growth and safety. The child is not a source to inherit the property in cases of divorce and maintenance. Though it is a decision, the court makes sure the child is not used and their healthy development is ensured. All courts dealing with child custody cases are duty bound to consider welfare of the minor child or children as the case may be. Parents, child custody has to prove that interest and welfare of the child shall be protected by him much better than the other opposite parent, irrespective of any law. I would suggest for child, both the parents are very important. Child is the biggest sufferer when he is deprived of love and company of either father or mother. So parents should leave their ego and selfishness and try their level best that child gets company and love of both without any sacrifice and any influence. Another observation, as my experience, mostly mother try to take custody of child being emotional, but that makes them difficult to settle again. And they end up sacrificing their life for a child who, when grows up, doesn't hold so much value for the same mother. This is just my experience, and I would suggest mothers to be more strong. And at the end of the day, child holds equal value for both parents when he grows up. I'll come up in my next video on more issues like maintenance. I hope this is helpful. I'm always available for any suggestions, any help, anytime. And this is generally for the awareness, purely awareness to make the common man, common mother, common father aware of custody of child and to understand the process. Thank you very much.